Alice is a lifelong cheerleader. It is her life. It's the only thing she knows. It's the only thing she can do, and it really defines her as a person. I think that's why it affects her so much when her spot on the team is in jeopardy.
You should write clumsy next. Right on Lewis's forehead.
Wait, you slipped and knocked down the pyramid, and I'm the bad guy because I fell on you?
You don't pay attention.
I'm sorry, were you still talking right now?
She's mad about being dumped.
I dumped him.
Not how I remember it.
It's complicated. Her relationship with Lewis is very complicated. They are on and off and back and forth, and she's really in love with him, but they just can't seem to work things out. My character has just injured her wrist, so she can't cheer. So Marty comes in as the replacement and not only tries to take Alice's spot on the team, but she tries to take her man as well. At least that's the way Alice sees it. She sees Marty as a very big challenge. Personally, and as far as her career goes in cheerleading on the squad, she really feels like Marty is just taking her spot, plain and simple, and she's not gonna let that happen.
Look, Alice, I know you didn't want me, but now that I'm actually here, I think we should just be friends.
You won't be around long.
Huh?
The Hellcats are short on flyers at a crucial moment.
That is the only reason a dangerously inexperienced outsider got a foot in the door.
I am what you might call the mean girl. When I can't cheer anymore, I kind of trying to get my power back, and I do some very manipulative and nasty things. You know, the rug has been pulled out from under her, and she's really doing the only thing that she knows how to do in order to get back on top of the world where she was before.